Hey everyone, and welcome to today's episode of Get Set Ma, in which we are going to be showing you 12 types of books that you will hear about when you start buying books for your kids. Some of them may be familiar, some of them not so much. So let's start. Please click to subscribe and turn on notifications. So this is going to be a fairly broad list of a bunch of books, and they are all storybooks or informative books, but it's the method they use to impart the information and the ways they use to engage your child that make them different and interesting. So some of these you can start using right when your baby is an infant. Some come into play later as their curiosity grows and they can handle books better too, and so on. We will be doing another video soon in which we will talk about the books for different age groups, so you can keep a lookout for that later as well. For now, let's dive into this list. So first up, high contrast books. These are mostly black and white. Sometimes there are one or two really bright primary colors thrown in as well. These are really good for infants because these simple images and illustrations and bold colors clearly stand out and are easy for a still developing eyesight to focus on. Next, board books. Now, what are board books? Board books are made of thicker paper, almost like a thick cardboard sometimes, and they are fairly durable, so an ideal buy for a younger child. Many books that we will talk about in this episode are actually board books, while some may be regular paperbacks. These are usually very easy to clean, with not easy to tear off pages, so ideal to use at a young age. Touch and feel books. This is a big favorite with the kids. They introduce babies to different kinds of textures through different themes or topics like animals, colors, food, etc. Lift the flap books. Again, a big hit with kids. Just imagine a curious little child just waiting to lift that little flap and see what's behind it. A great way to make learning fun and also encourage developing fine motor skills. And an excellent way to engage a child as their focus can easily wander off. At number 5, we have push, pull and slide books. Sometimes you see these and the lift the flap books combined into one book. These particular ones are a lot of fun for the kids as well, as by doing these actions of pushing, pulling and sliding, they discover things and learn new things as well. And again, this helps to strengthen their hands and fingers a bit too. Quiet books. They contain many activities to occupy your child, and these range from logical activities to games to motor skills, etc. You get different ones for different age groups. The book that we just flipped through right now is one of Ilham's quiet books from when she was younger. Cloth books. These are made of cloth and stitched really well, so a little baby cannot tear them and they are safe for a child to be around. For instance, this is an early cloth book of Ilham's. It has a simple to follow story with this little character of the baby that you can move from page to page. Activity books. These are of many kinds, so these are just a few in front of me here. They contain activities like coloring, join the dots, mazes, matching figures, colors, paper crafts, magnets that can be used in the books, etc. So obviously, as you can see, they help keep the kids busy and happily occupied, all the while learning something or the other. Sticker books. They could also come under the purview of activity books, but there are some completely solo sticker books too. Again, just peeling a sticker and sticking it also develops fine motor skills, and kids love stickers. It is a big favorite with them. Wipe and clean books. These are long-lasting, durable, and reusable books that your child can use for things like writing, pen control, etc. that require regular practice. So they function like a whiteboard, and you just have to wipe and they are ready to use again. There are activity books available like these too. And now you can also get slate-like reusable books to carry around as well. Books with sound. These are regular storybooks or other kinds of informative books that bring in sound to engage children as well, like these I have in front of me right here. Lastly, waterproof books. Yep, these exist too. And these are completely waterproof, so children can even use them in the bath to play. Just remember to clean them and dry them thoroughly between each use. And that's all we have for you in today's episode. Please remember to take a look at the links below this video, which will take you to all the books we mentioned in this episode. Please do share the video and give us a thumbs up if you liked it. Thank you for watching. Bye bye and take care.